Dandan, don't you think you should quit your job already?
I just defended that girl. Why?
I'm just worried that the guy you fought might want to get back at you.
Well, then I'll face that guy. Gael said that I did nothing wrong. Why should I be worried?
Hey.
I thought you understand me, Anna. You're fighting Salvador because that's what's right. Well, I'm right too. I didn't do anything wrong, and I'm on the right track. So why are you stopping me?
Dandan, I'm just worried about you.
Don't worry, Anna. I'll take care of myself.
You were right, ma'am. There's a Reform Philippines Movement member named Gregorio Calata. He has two children.
Mona Lisa Calata. I'm sure that's how he met Celeste.
That's affirmative, ma'am. His other child's Yvonne Calata.
Who else was he working with?
There's Eric Salazar. He was killed along with Gregorio during an ambush.
And Ramirez? Didn't he work with Ramirez?
He didn't, ma'am. But Celeste Ramos had an ally before, named Robert Ramirez. He was a security personnel at the Senate when former President Noble passed away.
His daughter's name's Katrina?
I have yet to confirm that.
Investigate the families of the members of that group after this, most especially Ramirez's. I'm wondering why they would ask Jorge regarding that. Find out what happened to the group members, and also their whereabouts, because there's a possibility that that group is the one helping Anna.
Thanks for coming with me, Mona.
There's no reason for me to hide anymore. Jorge knows me now, and I'm sure they're already having me investigated as we speak.
What about your family?
I talked to Yvonne. We'll move them to a safer location.
Thank you, Mona. I really have to do this right now. I just want to know what happened to my older sister. Good morning, ma'am. Are you the one who is in charge here?
Yes, I am. Your voice, it sounds familiar to me.
Oh. I've called this place many times before. I was inquiring about my sister. Her real name is Katrina Ramirez. Ma'am, I'm aware that you can't just give away the information of the orphans in here, but I just really need to know the family who adopted my sister. All I know about her is she was brought to the U.S. after adoption, but besides that, I don't know anything.
Well, just as I told you before, I really can't disclose that. It's confidential, miss.
I'm begging you. I need to know the family that adopted my sister. Was she really adopted? Or was she taken away against her will?
I'm really sorry, miss. I can't tell you. We don't let the children leave the walls of this orphanage until we're sure that they'd have a secure future ahead of them.
So if that's really true, then why don't you just tell me who adopted my sister?
I'm really sorry, but I can't help you.
Excuse me, ma'am. Mr. and Mrs. Santa Romana are here.
Oh, excuse me, ladies, but I need to speak with them right now.
Okay.
Hello.
Hello.
Please have a seat.
What the hell are you doing here, huh?
Why are you so angry with me?
Because you tricked me!
Shouldn't you be happy instead? It's what you want, to be free. But you went and got yourself arrested, Jorge. You want to get out of here? Why don't you just tell them what you really know? What do you really know, huh?
No matter what you do, I won't let you use me. Remember that!
What are you doing here? He confessed to the crime involving Vicente and Ana. I just want to know why he did it. And you? What are you doing here?
Just like you, I want to know the truth from him.
I think you're here to make sure he won't say anything against your family.
I don't need to explain to you. Now, if you're done, You can leave us now.
Ma'am, Robert Ramirez had a child named Katrina and another one named Juliana. I'm here at the orphanage. According to the staff, those two girls were brought here after Robert and his wife passed away. All right, ma'am. I'll give you an update later. Okay. What are you doing here?
I just want to know the truth. Jorge, if you tell me what really happened, then I can help you get out of here. You just need to tell me what happened to Vicente and Anna that night.
I was supposed to just scare them.
And who gave you the orders?
Nobody.
Then tell me, Jorge, why did you act on your own?
Because of my loyalty. Anna was spreading lies about the senator.
If you're really telling me the truth, then why did you have to involve Vicente too?
That Vicente wasn't supposed to get involved there. My plan was to kidnap Anna. But then he got in my way. And he followed us. Then he even tried to rescue Anna, so I had to shoot them both. I was really supposed to just scare them away, but things went out of hand.
I'm so sorry, sir, but all the information we have are confidential.
I understand. Okay, thank you anyway. Are you following me?
No, sir.
Hey, Gael. You're here already. We were waiting for you at the meeting. Where have you been?
I went to the station. I spoke to Jorge, the man who killed Anna's father.
And why did you do that?
Because I really want to know the truth, Diego. I'm sick and tired of hearing all those lies about what really happened.
So did you get what you wanted?
Yes. Jorge described everything to me in detail. The strange thing is that his statement didn't match what my mom told me about it.
Wait a minute. I'm confused. Can you please just explain it to me further?
Well, my mom and my godfather told me that Anna was a spy, and that she fled the country to get away. But according to Jorge, her family was leaving the house when he took her. Mom and godfather may have been lying to me.
So, Gael, are you saying to me now that Jorge and Anna are telling you the same thing? So, who among them are you going to believe now?
I'd be going against my own family if I believe Anna's story. I'd be sacrificing a lot. I need to carefully think this over. I still have to know the entire truth before I make a decision. I'll probe about it, Diego.
Yes, ma'am. We have her here. I'll take care of her. Don't worry about it. Why, doctor, you're up already.
Who was that, ma'am? Was that Miranda?
So why were you at the orphanage?
That's none of your concern.
Were you also looking for Katrina Ramirez? Hmm?
I don't know her.
Well, I know someone you know. Yvonne Calata. She's your sister, right? Well?
You'll leave her out of this.
That depends on what your answer will be. You got it?
I don't know anything.
So you want to do this the hard way, huh?
In most cases like yours, it's often the wife who gets the short end. Apart from the shame and emotional distress that I guarantee the annulment case will give you, you will surely have to spend a large amount of money for this.
I don't care about the money, attorney. Okay? Because I'm willing to spend any amount just to stop this annulment case from proceeding.
It will be emotional, I tell you. They'll surely use psychological incapacity as grounds.
I'll say it again. I won't allow my husband and I to be separated.
Then you must prove that both of you can still save your marriage. I'll be setting up a meeting with your husband's lawyer, and I'll see how we can still fix this. I'll be in touch, okay? Let me do the worrying. Excuse me.
Did you hear that, baby? I'm willing to sacrifice everything just to keep our family together. I will do anything, even the unimaginable. If Anna's really the reason why our family's falling apart, then I'll get rid of her myself, I promise you.
Wait, what about my schedule tomorrow, the night, the day after that, and then the weekend?
Sir, here's the document about the proposed project.
Excuse me.
Okay.
Anna, you're late.
I'm sorry, I'll catch up.
What are you doing?
I'll help them, I should be the one doing the demo now.
No need, you'll just disrupt the program. Help me give out survival kits. What are you doing?
Helping you. You want me by your side, right?
Aren't you even going to explain why you're late today?
I was looking for my sibling.
Dantan's missing?
Not him. My real sibling. My sister.
Wait, you're searching for your sister again?
You ask a lot of questions. Do you want to discuss it later? Dinner?
If you need help looking, just let me know soon.
Whenever you're ready.
And what do you mean?
When you're ready to believe me. I've been looking for her for years, so it's a big deal for me. But I know you're a very busy man.
Yes. What?
Is this true?
Well, yes. My men already got her.
But I can't leave the hospital to see her.
All right, then. I'll take care of her.
And I also found out something about their group. I'll send the investigator there to explain everything to you.
Okay.
Salvador?
Hey, Hillary, what are you doing here?
I'm just visiting you. Are you going out now?
Yes, I am. Well, the speaker invited me for dinner. Do you mind?
You don't have to ask permission, Salvador. I just dropped by. Go ahead.
Okay, I have to go. Miranda's sending somebody over. Let him in when he arrives.
Okay, Senator. She's there.
So where is she?
She's inside, Senator. She still wouldn't talk.
Xander, what did Anna say?
They went to the orphanage together, but they eventually split up.
Because up until now, Mona hasn't been answering my calls. And even in the hospital, nobody's seen her. Xander, I have a bad feeling.
Wait, I'll just call her again.
Hold on, I'll go to the orphanage now. I'll ask if anyone saw her.
I want to come with you.
No, just stay here now, in case she comes back. I'll go now.
Tell me what you know. Come on, speak up now. Tell me what you know.
You're the one the senator is expecting?
That's right. So where is Salvador?
He's inside, ma'am.
Thank you.
So your men caught this woman at the orphanage today?
That's right. She was at the orphanage where Robert Ramirez's kids were taken to.
Robert Ramirez?
New Year's Eve, year 2000.
Oh, right. Well, he was the one who got evidence against me, right?
You're right.
I don't understand. What does he have to do with our current problem, then?
Because of Celeste.
I really
think she gathered the relatives of
some of her friends. And they all formed
an alliance against us.
If that's the case, take them all down. We've already caught this Calata. You just have to look for the others. Okay? And make sure that you don't fail this time.
I'm already on it. I'm just prioritizing the children of that Robert Ramirez.
Hey, what are you doing here?
The senator's waiting for her.
It's not her.
I want to talk to my husband.
So, Mona Calata, your father is Major Gregorio Calata. He was a good man, and he had dignity.
You don't have the right to say my father's name.
And he went against me, and it's your time now. But it doesn't have to be this way. I let you and your sister live peacefully. You just need to tell me who else you're working with against me and where to find each one of them.
If you really think you can get answers from me, you're clearly mistaken. I'd rather be tortured and die than to betray and drag my friends down.
Oh. So are you going to choose your friends over all your siblings? All your siblings. You do have other siblings, right? Your mother remarried, remember? So you got other siblings. Do you want to drag them too? You want that?
You leave my family alone. Don't drag them into this. They don't know anything about what's been happening.
Oh dear. I'm getting impatient. Answer me already.
I'll never tell you anything. I said I won't tell you anything. You can do anything you want now. But this I'm promising you. They will bring you down. My sister will bring you down, I swear.
So you're as brave as your father. You won't last long. I'm sure of that.
Okay, just keep me posted.
Okay.
All right.
Anna.
You go ahead.
All right. See you later.
Are you off to somewhere now?
Well, no.
You know what? I'll take you up on your offer.
What offer?
Dinner, right?
Oh, I'm really sorry. Can we do it next time?
Let's cut to the chase, Anna. Why are you doing this?
Doing what?
This. You tried to get close to me after everything that happened.
Gael, you're the one who hired me.
So you mean all of this was just mere coincidence, huh?
Gael, I think you're thinking too much.
You're the reason why I became like this, Anna. Since you broke my trust.
You're the one who gave up on me first. If you only trusted me back then, even just a little, and you knew the truth, we wouldn't have to end up like this. You know what hurts even more? It's that I still trust you even now, Gael. That you'll help me fix all of this mess. Look, I'm really sorry. Now that I'm here with you, I'll try to bring back the Gael that I used to know. Open your eyes to the truth.
Hillary, what are you doing here?
I should be the one asking you that. Salvador, what place is this? And what are you up to right now, huh?
Wait. Hillary, wait. Let me explain everything to you, okay? But for now, you should go home. Let's go. Come on, let me explain everything.
Are you okay?
It's my foot.
Hold on.
Yeah.
I'll count to three, okay? Then after that, move your foot away.
Okay.
One, two, three! Anna, can you still walk?
I think I can walk.
All right. Are you okay? Anna, can you still walk?
I'll try.
Come on, I'll bring you to the hospital.
Hold on. Why did you do that?
You're really asking me that? Just hold on.
What were you doing there? Huh?
And why? What's really in there? What are you hiding from me, Salvador?
Nothing! I'm not hiding anything from you. I'll explain everything.
Huh. You always have an explanation for everything. But what I don't know is which of your explanations are true. I'm asking you, are you doing something illegal, Salvador?
No, I'm not doing any and would never do anything illegal in my life.
If that's the case, then tell me what's going on in that place, huh? You have men in there. What are you trying to hide?
Would you shut up?
Me?
Okay, I wanted that house very much, and I'm buying it to be my headquarters for the coming elections, okay? Hillary, I know I've made mistakes before, but I would never do anything that's against my conscience.
Salvador, if you want us to reconcile, you'll have to tell me every single thing that you were doing. So don't hide anything. It's the only way, Salvador.
Hello. Yes. Then why didn't you go?
I know you're hiding a lot from me, Salvador. But I can't confront you yet, because I still don't have evidence. I need to know everything that you're doing. I have to know if the accusations against you are all true. If I find proof that you are really a murderer, I will have you arrested.
Yes, Grandma, don't worry,
all
please.
Good,
I can come home right away. You don't need to come here, just stay and get some rest. Okay, then. Bye, Grandma.
Thank you. How's your foot now?
It's all right. But I'm more worried about you and what happened to your arm.
Don't worry about me. The doctor told me I'll be fine in a week. What matters is that you're okay.
Miss de Masalin?
Yes?
Based on your x-ray, no fractures. You only sustained a tendon and soft tissue injury. That's why your left foot is swollen now. So for now, you'll have to use crutches to somewhat help your uninjured extremity to balance your weight. But after 1 week, you could still feel pain in your foot, but you won't be needing crutches by then.
But for now, I can go home, right, Doc?
Yes.
Thank you.
All right, I'll leave you two alone.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Gael. But you shouldn't have done that. I can look after myself. Now you're hurt because of me.
Anna, you're working for me, okay? You're my responsibility. If only I could, I'd do anything it takes to protect my employees. By the way, weren't you chasing someone? Who's that?
I don't know who he was, but I'm not surprised that I'm being monitored. And you know who my enemies are.
I'll arrange your discharge papers.
Hello, Xander.
Anna, we have a problem. Until now, we still can't find Mona, and nobody even saw her today.
What? No one's seen her? Wait, I'll help you look for her tonight. The doctor said I can be discharged anyway.
Doctor? Where are you?
Jonathan, right?
You need anything?
I just came here to thank you. Because of you, nothing bad happened to me. Here, I have something for you. Is 5,000 enough?
What's that for?
A reward. I'm sure you need it.
Are you thanking me or are you insulting me?
Why are you being so grouchy? I'm just trying to be nice here.
Ma'am, I can't accept that. I didn't help you because I wanted something in return, but because it was the right thing to do. Next time, take care of yourself.
By the way, my name's not Ma'am. It's Ashley.
You're such an imbecile. You only had one job, yet you still blew it.
Ma'am, because your son rescued her.
Because of that, he got hurt too.
What?
Ma'am, I didn't mean to hurt him.
Don't you ever let me see you again.
Mom.
Gail.
Where are you? I was just going to ask you to bring some things to the hospital.
I'll just come visit you later, Mom. I'm in the hospital.
What? Another hospital?
What are you doing there? And what happened to you?
I'm here in Fairlane General Hospital. Anna was assaulted.
And who?
I have no idea, okay? But you might know who did it.
Well, I don't know anything. Just take care, okay? Yes, Samantha.
Grandma? Grandma, it's you.
Xander, where is Anna? Is she with you now?
Oh, no, I just got here as well. She's inside the emergency room.
All right, let's
go. Okay, let's go.
Anna! Anna!
Grandma, I told you not to come over here.
Oh, well, because I can't help it. I had to see if you're okay.
Did you see who assaulted you both?
Well, not his face. Everything happened too fast.
What are you doing here? Huh?
Look. Gael was the one who brought me to the hospital. He helped me when I was assaulted. If it weren't for him, this would have been worse.
Because Anna's working for me, Grandma. So I guess it's normal that I look out for my injured employees.
You're working for that man?
Yes, Grandma. He's our company's client.
Why is this happening, huh? Huh?
Why don't you sit down first?
What are you doing? No matter what you do, you can't escape from us. Come here! Come here! Cracker! Over here! Hey! Wake up!
What's wrong?
Why are you sleeping?
Yvonne, where are you going?
I'm going to look for my sister.
Hey, hold on! Won't you relax? Can we just wait for Xander and Anna to iron out our plans first?
Chito, I just can't stay here and wait for them. My sister needs me right now.
Yvonne, you can't do this alone, okay? You can't find your sister by yourself. We're all your friends, remember? Please trust us on this. I swear we'll find your sister.
I don't want to be separated from her. When we decided to join this group, I promised her that I would protect her at all costs. But now I can't do anything for her.
Yvonne, what are you talking about? We will rescue your sister, wherever she is right now. Do you understand that?
Thank you. I'll just fetch your discharge papers, ma'am. Excuse me.
Don't be in a rush. You still have to recover.
I'm fine, Grandma. Don't worry about me.
So when were you going to tell me that you're working for Gael? Anna, why did you choose to keep this from me?
Grandma, I just had to take that job.
With all the companies out there, why did you choose to work for Gael? Don't you think that what you're doing now is just too risky? You're starting to get me worried. Your actions are just putting you at greater risk.
Look, you don't have to worry. Just remember that I know Gael all too well, and how he manipulates people. And this time I won't let him fool me. No need to worry, okay?
Yes. Thank you so much for helping out Anna. But you can leave now.
Well, I won't go home unless Anna gets discharged here. After what happened to us, I can't be at peace.
You really have no idea who did this to Anna? Perhaps it's someone whom you often interact with.
Gael? Hey, what happened to your arm?
How did you know I'm here?
Well, your mom told me about it. Come on, let's go home now.
Sam, I can't go home by myself.
What? You have no driver. So you plan to drive with your injury?
Samantha, I appreciate your concern, okay? Thank you. But like what I said, I can go home by myself. Just go home. You need to rest now.
Xander.
Gael already left. Shouldn't you be on your way with him?
Believe me. I want nothing more than to be with him. But with what's happening, Right now, I'm the last person whom he wants to see.
Well, I heard about your... separation.
Temporary separation. Let me be honest, Xander. I don't want to ever see my husband and Anna together. And I'm so sure you don't want that too. I saw the way you looked at her. I saw it when you were pretending to be married.
What's with this conversation? Excuse me.
Well, Gael and I clearly didn't have to pretend to be a married couple. So you may as well want to tell Anna to stop flirting with my husband. Look, Xander. I know we both want the same thing at this moment. Why don't we help each other out?
Sam, I won't be a part of your schemes against Anna.
Well, all I want is to keep Gael away from Anna. And we both know very well, Xander, that them being together will just be a disaster. So, once you're ready to accept my offer to you, call me.
Hello, ma'am. I already have the files of the children. I'll send it to you now.
Okay, thank you. I'm so sorry. I couldn't make it to your talent show. I just had to fix something regarding Salvador's campaign.
It's okay, Mama. I understand.
I have an idea. How about I treat you to your favorite ice cream place? You can eat what you want from there to make up for it.
Can I bring my new friend?
Of course. And who?
It's Samantha.
Samantha? Samantha! Come here!
Hello, ma'am.
Hello. Want to come with us? We'll go eat some ice cream now.
I'm not sure if I'm allowed to join you, ma'am.
Samantha, we're very close with your mother and father. So don't worry. I'll just tell them later on that I brought you with me.
Samantha! Mom will treat us to lots of ice cream! Come with us!
Let's go? This child really is Samantha. She once had a birthmark on her face. What kind of twist of fate is this?